Welcome to Engineer's Kitchen. Today we want to talk about one of our most used modules in Zenon, the extended trend module. Zenaida, what have you brought for us?
Yeah, I want to show you some new features in the ETM, so in the extended trend module. We worked on that to make the engineering in the extended trend more comfortable and more efficient for our users. Therefore, now the ETM supports the styles. We can configure a curve style, for example, where we can define properties as the curve type, the color, and the width, or a scale style. We can link the styles afterwards to different objects at the ETM, for example, the data type, the variable, axis, or curves itself. If we, for example, link it at the data type directly, all the variables of this data type will automatically have this style linked. If you want to customize it, we can still override it either at the variable or at the curve. Where we can override it, I'll show you right now. When we perform a screen switch function, we can select here in the representation page which styles we want to use for our diagram. And at the curves, we can select...
Also for the curves, okay.
Also for the curves, we can select, for example, the curve style. And here we see then the properties disabled, which come from the style. And here at the axis, we can link our scale style. There we can, let's say, define the number of ticks or the type of the axis, if you want the linear or logarithmic, for example.
Okay, so you can really centrally define all the styles, all the layouts, without having to manipulate anything afterwards.
Yes, so the big advantage of this is if you want to exchange something, you just have to adapt one spot afterwards.
Yeah. So following one of our core principles of the Zenon. Excellent.
Yeah, and since we're already in the screen switch function, I would like to show you another cool feature, which is the substitution. We can now substitute different objects of the ETM as the curves itself, or let's say a visibility variable or the variables we use for describing the titles of the axis. There are two ways of substitution. Either we use a static substitution, then we just write in the text we want to replace variable X by variable Y, or we use the index substitution. Okay. Therefore, we have to define some a replacement rule as we have it in here. So, which means all the variables with index 1 will be replaced by any other parameter. Okay. Yeah. And at the runtime, then we will see the replaced variable, so not the original one anymore.
Okay. But then I still can remain with one function and just substitute the data behind, and the curves and everything is ready-made.
Exactly. You have to only once project the screen. And since we also wanted to have some really nice to see features, we also worked on our feature which is called Popup trend. We really easy define this. We only have to link a context menu to our dynamic element. It can be any. And at the context menu, we can really easy and quickly project this. We just have to add here some basic settings as the screen we want to use. And the time filter, and here at the type we have a new action type which is the show extended trend. And in the runtime afterwards, we really cool via right click can see a pop-up trend for our variable.
And this is now also the ETM, this pop-up.
This is the ETM screen. You can configure it and design it however you want. And to make it even more easy, we have one more feature. Without any projecting needed, we can just use our drag and drop feature, where we can just take a variable from any dynamic element and drag it to our trend. And we see the variable is added there. And we also can do a multi-select in here. For example, we can take three variables at the same time. And without needing of any engineering work behind.
Also great performance, I must say. So there's no flickering, there's nothing bad happening there.
And then if you want to go to detail, we can also now do some mouse manipulations and not only via MDI buttons.
Very impressive. Zenaida, thanks for these impressive insights about our extended trend module. As a small thank you, I want to offer you one of our Engineer's Kitchen t-shirts.
Thank you, it was a pleasure being here and joining you.
Thanks for joining us at Engineer's Kitchen. What a delicious episode of COPA-DATA's Engineer's Kitchen. If you are still hungry, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.